A centrist? Somebody called H3 Clip Factory says, shout out, by the way. Oh, we should have Gabe send Hassan a cameo. That's a good idea. Sorry about the Hogwarts legacy controversy. Woo! H3 Clip Factory.
Ethan, great movie.
Shout out, by the way. Why is XUC allowed to play Hogwarts Legacy? I thought that was like a cancelable offense.
That game is so fun.
Oh, you fucked up, bro.
Oh, no.
You literally, you know what? I was surprised.
No one got mad when I streamed it. They were mad that I picked the wrong house.
Yeah, well, I think people need to watch your stream to get mad about it.
Oh, damn.
Oh, Jesus. Fucking.
Sorry. I don't know why.
Fucking
I
was annihilated.
Sorry,
I can
bro.
Come back, but I'm not gonna.
No, you. No, come I'm back. No, what do no. you got?
Then I got nothing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Only got what you give.
No, that's not true. People watch your stream.
Yeah.
Oh, people were. Oh, it was Liver King. It was Liver King post steroids that you identified as he had the energy of the Looney Tunes character. Yeah.
Right. Here it is.
Let's give this one a try.
A character.
Okay, so I mean, there's a lot to unpack here.
Character.
Give this one.
Is he joking or serious?
He seems very serious.
Like, love, you know this guy better than anyone. Is he serious or kidding?
Yeah, he's probably serious. Yeah. That's the beauty of it.
Does he not?
A character.
Why does he say character?
Character.
Hey, he has an accent just like me.
Right, that's fair.
Character.
That's awesome. That I like that the alternate world of Harry Potter where they use carrots instead of wands. This game looks fun as fuck, though, AB.
It is.
Really? Does it?
It does. It looks really good.
It's sort of, it gives me sort of like Elden Ring. It's not Elden Ring level, of course.
Is it open world?
Yes.
And it's like a role. It's like a RPG.
Yeah.
That sounds fire. You don't play as Harry Potter. You're just in the Harry Potter world.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's like 100 years before.
I just...
Character!
I'm just a hater. I've never... We've discussed this, but Harry Potter is
XQC, not my thing. This could be us if you stop playing around. Let's make it happen. Yeah, sorry about that joke, AB.
No, I don't mind.
AB actually... is a great Twitch streamer. You guys should check it out. Starkiller.
Starkiller.
AB Starkiller. Oh, thank you.
He's streaming Hogwarts Legacy, apparently.
Thank you. Thank you. You make fun of me all you want if I'm going to keep getting plugs.
Yeah.
My work friends are the only people I'm subscribed to on Twitch. That's why I made an account.
Shout out.
Are you giving them your Prime?
Absolutely. Are you kidding?
How do you decide who gets it?
I haven't decided who got something.
You don't know what I'm talking about.
I don't know what you're talking about. I just know that I do not get ads.
Think of the Prime.
Got it.
Very good.
Think of the Prime.
Yeah, everybody go watch AB and then fucking
AB Starkiller?
Shame him for playing this transphobic game.
Can you say it like that? AB Starkiller on Twitch? I'll just clip that.
You're going to clip it? What are you going to do with that?
I'm just kidding.
Promoted post, Instagram?
Yeah. You,
yes.
Ethan says AB Starkiller on Twitch.
There's a clip. Go look for the clip.
Hogwarts Legacy. Anyway, yeah, I can't. Shame on you, AB. Shame on you.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, we've been through enough. Haven't trans people been through enough?
There's a trans character in the game.
Oh.
Oh well,
trans people worked on
it. That's pretty progressive, isn't it?
Yeah.
In the Marvel universe,
I guess the question is, do they cancel each other out? I think maybe they do. I don't know.
Yeah.
Not for me to say. So,
yeah.
I guess,
well, yeah. Something tells me J.K. Rowling didn't have too much to do with the development of this video game. I think she just sits in her castle and tweets all day at this point.
I actually
saw a thing about the trans character in the game, and I couldn't tell if it was a meme or not. Does it really have like kind of
Where's that kind of like Wendy, a sus name?
So some people are talking about the name, but the name actually it means rebirth, I believe, in some kind of mythology.
Oh, okay,
so
interesting.
That's where it came from.
I really couldn't discern if people were just like trolling or not with what I was seeing.
I do want to play that game, but I mean, I don't stream it anyway. But do you think that it's actually, this is a big conversation. Is obviously I support trans rights. Mm-hmm. So is it antithetical to supporting trans rights by playing that?
Well, if you buy it, she gets money. So do you, you know, want to boycott her and not give her money?
It's like,
I mean, okay. that's all it really,
look,
I mean.
She's already like a billionaire.
Yeah, I mean, it's not going to make like a huge difference in her bottom line or anything.
Like how many
but,
fucking people worked on that game?
Of course.
Made money. The game, a labor of love.
Including trans people who worked on the game.
Okay, that's good. Interesting. And like, she's not even involved. Like, who cares that she makes money? She make money when you fucking take a shit at this point.
Yeah, it's like trying to protest Disney. I mean, of course, I support the trans community, but like everything that we have on our daily, our iPhones, you know, child labor, you know, everything is rooted in some kind of, you know, fucked up evil. So
as Disney's Pinocchio,
that is true. We give money to lots of bad things in our life without a second thought. So that is a fair point.
So we are saying we are giving the green light on Hogwarts Legacy.
I won't be playing it personally.
I might get it.
But
I
also fucking hate Harry Potter, so that was never, it's a non-issue for me. So
it just looks like sick. It's like a big AAA game, right? Like they worked a lot on
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a big game.
Dude, the combat is.
It's super fun.
It's a lot of fun.
Hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah. I'm actually super glad Harry Potter's not in it, though. I'm over his dumbass. you sent me a Hassan tweet, but I can't read it, so.
Tudja? Oh, right, it's private.
Is it Tudja?
Tudja?
I don't know. Hassan has been getting a lot of hate.
For what? What did he do?
Nothing.
He
didn't even play I don't it. Understand
he
why people
said
are mad
he's
at
not
him.
Playing it.
Yeah, he's not.
And he still got shit.
He suggested, I think at one point he suggested he wanted to play it and do like a gameplay fundraiser, something like he's done in the past where like every time he dies, he donates some money to like a trans charity or something to like offset that. But I think he got a lot of shit for that. So eventually he was just like, fine, I won't play it. But now I think he's still getting shit about it. And it's just like, I don't know. That dude can't win. I mean, you know how it is. It's the same with you. It's like, yeah.
Yeah, I have the same. I can't win no matter what I do. I donated $100,000 fucking dollars from my own pocket. And that sprung a whole conspiracy of hate videos about how it was fake. About, you know, it's like, it's crazy. Yeah. I did see a clip of him saying, I'm just not going to play it because people can get mad at me if I do. People will get mad at me if I don't. He's like, I'm just not going to play it just to avoid. He said, I've never felt worse at any point in my career than I do now. At the heels of almost raising $1 million. Oh, I forgot to mention, I donated $10,000 to his campaign. We need to mention that. Yeah. I hate the left. I hate the right. I literally want to quit. The only thing keeping me going is not caving to psychos. I mean, I've been there, bro.
Yeah, I think he's having a tough week.
Oh, by the way, Leftovers is not happening because he's doing some Twitch thing, so. But, so yeah, there's no episode tomorrow.
You know, there was even a website that was tracking who was playing the game, which streamers were playing it, but it got taken down or removed.
By who?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure the details.
Yeah, I'm not trying to boast or anything, but if you go to top donors, I am on this list of donating $10,001, of course, so that I could be on the top of these. Let's face it, I don't want to say that they weren't generous, but at a certain point, you just got to acknowledge that I'm higher up on the list.
By a dollar.
I was wondering what the one is for. That's so funny.
Yeah.
that $12,500 donation right there, anonymous. Yeah.
That's me.
Cam, gotcha. Why are you lying? It's me.
Gotcha.
Okay. Wow. Super generous. Show me the receipt.
I'll show you after the show.
Yeah, I don't like.
I did donate it, but not $12,000.
Hold on, let me Photoshop something real quick.
Yeah, and I don't like to brag or boast or anything. Obviously, I did it for the Turkish and the Syrian people who are devastated. Horrible tragedy. But it is nice to see it up there, right there in the top five.
It looks good. It looks
yeah.
Good.
And I did want to tell you guys about it because...
Yeah, you didn't?
What?
You didn't want to mention it?
I didn't want to mention it on the show, but I thought in the context of what we were talking about, it was important, atmospheric.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Do you think it would be smart to put maybe the YouTube URL instead of Ethan Klein? Can generate some traffic.
It's too late. It's too late, but that would have been a good idea. Follow me on, subscribe to my channel on YouTube.
That's what they did above you. I thought that was pretty
smart.
Wait,
this is a promo?
I think so.
Telegram?
Or probably not. I don't want to. Probably not.
It's not very clear if it is, so it's probably not.
Yeah.
Actually, I saw Hassan gave 25K. I was like, oh shit, okay, I got to pony up. Super sad, though. I don't really want to get into it in depth because it's just...
Dude, the videos are so nuts.
So and fucked like, up.
Yeah. Not at all. I mean, not at all to try and make it about Americans or anything, but having lived through a major earthquake, not as big as that.
Not even close.
Yeah, like, I mean, this almost, is it was 10 like times bigger 8. Than the Northridge earthquake that happened when Ethan and I were...
That
we're young here
too,
in Los Angeles, and that is, I mean, burned in my memory as one of the most traumatic things that's ever happened to me, and this is 10 times as big. I can't even fathom.
Two.
Yeah, and two back-to-back. It's
I don't think people who
insane.
Don't live in, like, earthquake territories understand just how massive a 7.8 earthquake is. That is, like, insane.
Yep.
It's pretty wild. That shit scares me a lot, because in Sweden, there's, like, nothing that can kill me, nature-wise. No animals, no natural disasters.
What about Norwegian people?
Vikings? You know, well, Viking raids? Well,
the Danes. The Danes
Of course. Not the Danes.
The Norwegians are fine. But the Danes, yeah. But yeah, nothing like... It scares me very much to go to LA when it comes to that kind of stuff.
I mean, it's a very rare thing, obviously. But
sure,
when it does happen,
it's very...
We're due for a big one.
Yeah. But not to scare you away, but... We're,
not,
we're
not
up.
That worried, but.
The difference is that in LA, things are built with wood, which is more flexible, and also things are just kind of newer. Like, as I understand, in Turkey, a lot of this, or in Syria, a lot of the stuff that collapsed was kind of like hastily built and not up to code and stuff. Because,
or just like really
reasons.
Old stuff.
Yeah, old stuff. Because they're already struggling, and it's just fucking tragic when this stuff happens. It's so sad. So my heart goes out to the Turkish and Syrian people and all affected. If you guys want to donate, it is...
This blew my mind. Did you see about this? This castle, 2,000-year-old castle, got destroyed in the earthquake. It'd been there for... Before Jesus walked the earth, this castle has been standing there.
Yeah.
Just devastated. Insane.
That is crazy. I mean, those things are built to last, though. Goddamn, 2,000
clearly.
Years.
Yeah.
Shit. What's the link? What's the easy link to shout out? Because this is like a weird.
Well, Hassan's fundraiser is still ongoing. Here, let me grab the link.
I just want to know the link, so if people want to donate, they can.
We can put it in the description, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah, but you know what? I get the same shit Hassan does. It's annoying. You just can't win, no matter what you do. I get really frustrated by people on the left lately sometimes because it's like there's people on the left who they expect from anybody perfection. You have to be absolutely perfect. And if there's a blemish, if you've ever done something wrong, they want you to... It's like... They want you to be guilty forever. Like, there's no forgiveness.
Purity test stuff, yeah.
It's so gross.
Yeah, it's, you know.
I don't even understand the end goal of that kind of behavior that I see, like, on the left specifically. Where they criticize other leftist people as not being lefty enough. Like Hassan, for example. I mean, they do it to me all the time, too. It's like...
I mean, I think, you know, it's an outgrowth of the fact that people on the left are generally more self-critical. People on the right are much, in my experience, it seems that they are much more willing to just sort of ignore contradictions or, you know, things that go against the narrative on their side with other people for the sake of... clawing power, they're not that purity stuff is not really that important on the right, or as important as it is to
someone
people on the left.
Someone said, Ethan, you're not a leftist. How am I not a leftist? What am I? Wait, genuinely, what do you think I am? Ethan, you're a liberal, not a leftist. Oh, what? Okay. I don't know what the fuck that means. What's the difference between a leftist and a liberal? Is it synonymous?
There is a difference. Generally, we have to get into it.
I mean, what do you want from me?
In the parlance of
thank you, Gwen
American
Mellon.
Politics, Ethan is definitely on the left. I understand it's more nuanced than that, and especially in Europe, the liberal parties are generally considered center right. That is somewhat the case here in the United States too. You know, the Democratic Party, by international standards, would probably be considered a center right party. I do think that you're
a centrist. Somebody called H3 Clip Factory says, shout out, by the way. I'm trying to get you guys unbanned. The H3 Industrial Complex ran into a snag. They thought they were impersonating me, so I'm working with YouTube to get that resolved. But
yeah.
How am I a centrist? Actually, now people are saying I'm far right. Okay, I see. Whatever. Who cares? Stupid labels. Doesn't matter. I'm whatever's pro blowing up.
Okay.
Oh my God.
I was gonna say pro blowing up public Cheers discourse. Because
yes, we gotta blow this discourse wide open, baby. That's right.
Conversation is everything. You know, if we can work through anything, if only we come together and talk, I'm gonna explode on the scene with this. Wonderful conversations. It's
somebody in the chat said Ethan should take a political compass test. You know, we actually did for Leftovers once, and we didn't end up doing the segment. But I remember Ethan's results were...
I'll take it live right now. Oh, Wendy's! Here, I'll do it live.
It takes a while. I think I could probably find the results.
It was very left.
It was very left.
Yeah. It was on the bottom.
The libertarian left... in that normal compass that everybody takes. Those things are kind of goofy and not totally accurate, but I mean, it gives you a good sense of at least the ballpark you're in. Yeah, let me see if I can dig up the results from before.
We got a new White Claw Gabe classic, by the way.
Logan, hey!
I really like this vertical he's got into of wishing, eulogizing.
Eulogizing, yes. He's very good at it.
Since the dearly departed. So here's a new one from Gabe.
Logan, hi there. I'm sorry your mama had died during the Christmas holiday. Fuck me, fuck yeah. And I'm sorry that your mom died around your birthday too, motherfucker. Fuck me, fuck yeah.
So good.
Logan, you deserve better. I hope you feel better. Fuck me, fuck yeah. Sorry your mom passed away, and I want to wish you the best, Logan. Best wishes from the White Claw game, and I want to wish you the best. Good luck, and fuck me, fuck yeah. Hopefully things get better, Logan. I want to wish you the best. Fuck me, fuck.
You know, I love the angle. Also, I love going, I'm sorry that your wife and mom died. I hope things get better.
I hope you get a new wife and
like
mom.
This man's life is fucking decimated.
Oh, my God.
I hope things get better for you. he's the best, man. I'll tell you what.
Bless his heart.
Yeah, you bitch.
That is White Claw Gabe, everybody. Oh, we should have Gabe send Hassan a cameo. That's a good idea. Sorry about the Hogwarts Legacy controversy. Woo! Fuck, baby, fuck.
Maybe in like a week. He seemed pretty upset about it today, so...
Sorry being canceled for doing a donation stream.
Yeah.
I got all
that. Bro, I'm telling you, I donated $100,000 fucking dollars, and all I got was grief for it.
Greedy.
Yeah, it's
You're
wild.
So greedy.
Crazy.
Just on a basic level, as someone who didn't really, I wasn't involved in politics at all before I moved out here, seeing people like, you know, you and Dan and Hassan, who, you know, are always arguing for the left their whole careers, and then you say one thing, slip up, or say one thing that they don't like, then that's it.
They're fake.
Ruthless.
That's They're a phony.
That's it.
I'm one bad day away from being a grifter. You'll see.
Yeah. I gotta pee. I'll be right back. And then this is awesome. So Mr. Beast, you guys may know this guy. He's blowing up on TikTok. This
Mr. Beast?
Keith Lee.
Oh.
You guys know him. Some of y'all must know him, right?
Yeah, I know him. Mm-hmm.
So he's been like reviewing small business family restaurants. And it's very wholesome content, and everybody loves this guy. And so Mr. Beast reached out or left a comment and said, review my chocolate bars. And Keith responded and said, I will review your chocolate bars under these conditions. I don't remember what he said, but Mr. Beast agreed. Now, when I saw this, I was like, I know those chocolate bars are not good. I mean, they're mid, and that's fine. They're like $2 chocolate bars. But my question was like, I know this guy, he's not going to love it. So I was curious how this was going to go down. And I got to say, Keith kept it real. He gave them mediocre scores, and Mr. Beast gets visibly angry, actually. It's quite good.
Just real quick, before we move on too far, I found it. This was your test result. So, yeah.
Very not authoritarian. Very not right. I'm almost as live as you can get. I'm almost in the bottom left. What's more live than that? Full on anarchy?
Basically.
I don't know.
I think it's the fact that you keep calling it lib, though, that, like, again, it's a very loaded word because it means different things in different places and yada yada.
I'm not in the trenches that deep.
And yeah, I mean, these aren't like an end all be all by any means, but.
I'm no wonk.
You're no wonk. And you're also, I don't think, a Nazi. I'm going to go ahead and say it. I don't think Ethan Klein's a Nazi, people.
I don't think
he's a Nazi.
Thank you for coming out and saying that. H3 Clip Factory.